the concept of primary health care came into existence following a joint WHO-UNICEF international conference at Alma Ata on 12 September 1978. The Alma Ata conference called for the acceptance of the WHO goal of health for all by 2000 AD and proclaimed primary health care as a way of achieving health for all. In this short video, we covered the definition, the characteristics, the elements, and the principles of primary health care. Primary healthcare by definition is the essential healthcare based on practical, scientifically sound, socially acceptable methods and technology that is made universally accessible to individuals and families in the community through full participation and the cost that the community and the country can afford to maintain at every stage of their development in the spirit of self-determination. Essentially, it's just essential healthcare. Okay, so it's healthcare that you're giving. Now, the healthcare that you're giving, you should make sure that it's practical, it's scientifically proven. So it should be scientifically proven that the treatment that you're offering should have positive effect on the disease that you're curing. It should also be socially acceptable, and you should also use technology to make things faster and better. Now, the treatment that you're offering or the essential healthcare that you're offering should be accessible to individuals and families in the community, and they should have full participation, and the cost of this essential healthcare should be affordable for the community and for the country. And you got to maintain the primary healthcare at every stage of its development in the spirit of self-determination. Coming to the characteristics of primary healthcare according to the Alma Ata Declaration, so there are four characteristics that are easy and that we can learn. So the first one is that it should address the main healthcare problem. So obviously, because it's primary healthcare, it's supposed to address your healthcare problems. That is your first point. The second point is that the second point speaks about who are the people who are involved. So on local levels, who are the people involved? So your doctors, nurses, midwives, all these people are involved. So this is your second point. Now this is saying that primary healthcare is relying on these people. Now it also says that how you can sustain this entire primary healthcare. So that is the third point. Third point, you remember the keyword, which is sustain. For the fourth point, you have to talk about how primary healthcare also depends on other sectors apart from the health sector. So these are your four broad headings. Coming to each one. So your primary healthcare should address the main health problems, providing promotive, preventive, curative, as well as rehabilitative services. So it should promote good health, it should also prevent diseases from occurring, it should cure diseases that have occurred, and it should also provide rehabilitative services. So if the person has suffered from an illness or an injury that has led to some skills that have been lost, and you know, he's not able to perform certain functions, so we are able to rehabilitate this patient. For example, if he's unable to walk or if he's unable to eat, so we are supposed to rehabilitate or provide services that allow him to use or to maximize his self-sufficiency. Coming to the second point, where we spoke about how it relies on local levels on healthcare workers. So physicians, nurses, midwives, auxiliaries, community workers, traditional practitioners. So your primary healthcare on the local level is being run by these people. Now, how do you sustain it? You have to sustain it by integrated, functional, and mutually supported referral systems, leading to progressive priority to those most in need. So the system that is there, it should be very mutually supportive, which should help us prioritize the people who require the treatment the most. The fourth and the last point speaks about how other sectors are also involved in providing primary health care. So the agriculture, animal husbandry, food industry, education, housing, public works, communications, all of these are involved in providing primary health care. And it demands the coordinated efforts of all these sectors. Next, let's discuss about the elements or the components of primary healthcare. So obviously, because this is healthcare, you are supposed to be able to provide treatment of common diseases and injuries. So appropriate treatment of common diseases and injuries and provision of essential drugs is something that would first come into my head. Now, apart from that, there are certain things that primary healthcare system also does. So we said that it provides promotive, preventive, curative, right? So this comes under curative, where it's providing treatment and providing essential drugs. Let's come to promotive. So under promotive, your primary healthcare should be able to promote food supply and proper nutrition, as well as it should be able to provide safe water and basic sanitation to the people. So for promoting good health, these are the basic things that are required. So this is the job of the primary healthcare. Apart from that, there is something called preventive. So how do you prevent a disease? You have to educate the population. You educate the population about the prevailing health problems and the methods of controlling them. Apart from that, the primary healthcare should also have maternal and child healthcare, which should also include family planning. And this center should also be able to provide immunization against infectious diseases and should be able to prevent and control endemic diseases. So first, we spoke about the obvious ones. That is, it should be able to provide treatment, it should be able to provide essential drugs. Then we started speaking about preventive, promotive and curative. So under preventive, we spoke about education. So you educate the patient. Under promotive, we spoke about how there should be food supply, proper nutrition and even safe supply of water and sanitation. Apart from that, we spoke about maternal and child healthcare. So it should also have family planning. And the primary healthcare system should be able to immunize against infectious diseases and prevent and control endemic diseases. Next up, we talk about the principles of primary healthcare. The first principle of primary healthcare is equitable distribution. So health services must be shared equally by all people, irrespective of their ability to pay. So whether rich or poor, urban or rural, everybody must have access to health services. At present, the health services are mainly concentrated in major towns and cities. And the people who require it the most, the needy and the vulnerable population present in the rural areas, are the worst hit. This is termed as social injustice. The second principle is community participation, which states that every individual, family and community must be involved in the promotion of their own health and welfare, planning, implementation and maintenance of health services. So every individual, family and community must be actively involved in promotion of their own health. The third principle is intersectoral coordination, which says that there should be planning with other sectors to avoid duplication of services. We just spoke about the characteristics of the Almaty Declaration, where we said that there is involvement of other sectors like the agriculture, animal husbandry, food, communication, housing, etc. in the functioning of the primary healthcare. So there should be intersectoral coordination. Apart from that, there should also be coordination in the health sector. For example, the oral health should be integrated in general health programs. So this is going to help avoid duplication of activities. The next one is appropriate technology. So by definition, it means that the technology that you're using should be scientifically sound. It should be acceptable to those who apply it and also to those for whom it is used. It should be adaptable to local needs and it should be maintained by the people themselves with the principle of self-reliance, that is the community and the country should be able to afford this kind of technology. So the technology that you're using should be scientifically sound, it should be acceptable. Apart from that, it should be adaptable and the people should be able to maintain this kind of technology. They're using the term appropriate. So the term appropriate means that this technology that you are using, it is scientifically sound, but apart from that, it should be appropriate in the sense that it should be effective. It should be simple to design and use. The people who are using it should be able to easily understand it, and the health workers or the health volunteers should also be able to understand the technology. It should be capable of further development, and again, it should be acceptable to those who apply it and for those for whom it is used. So this is the meaning of appropriate. So apart from being scientifically sound, it should be effective, acceptable, it should be easily understood. You know, it should be capable of further development and it should be acceptable. So this is the meaning of appropriate technology. The last one is focus on prevention. So the treatment of illness and rehabilitation to be accompanied with emphasis on preventive measures. So cool, you should treat the people who have been affected by the disease. You should rehabilitate the patient. But there should be a lot of emphasis that should be given on preventive measures. That is your last point, that is focus on prevention. So these are your five principles of primary healthcare. equitable distribution, community participation, intersectoral coordination, appropriate technology, and focus on prevention. So here's summarizing this entire mind map for you. This is primary healthcare, where we studied the definition, the characteristics, the elements, and the principles of primary healthcare. In the definition, you should remember these 4 points, that it should be practical, scientifically sound, socially acceptable, and you should use technology. It should be made universally acceptable through full participation at the cost of the community and the country can afford. In the characteristics, we studied about how you should address the main problem. Apart from that, it relies on local levels on some people and it is sustained by certain things. Apart from that, there is intersectoral coordination. So you can use that point, you can use it here. And you can speak about how there is involvement of other sectors in primary healthcare. Under elements, we studied about preventive, promotive, curative, all these components of primary healthcare, where we studied about where there should be appropriate treatment that should be provided, there should be essential drugs that should be present. We also spoke about how there is education that is very important, promotion of food supply, promotion of water, promotion of basic sanitation that is very important. We spoke about how there should be maternal and child healthcare and how the primary healthcare center should be able to immunize people against infectious diseases and prevent endemic diseases. Next, we spoke about the principles, where we spoke about equitable distribution, community participation, intersectoral coordination, appropriate technology, and focus on prevention. So that's it about primary healthcare. If you guys want this mind map, you can DM me on my Instagram page and I shall provide you a PDF of this mind map. You can also tell me which topic I should cover in the next video, and see you in the next video.